In this example, we are given that 100 volt DC is applied across a solenoid. A steady current of 1 ampere flows in it. It must be because of some resistance in the solenoid, as there won't be any effect of inductance in a steady state for a DC voltage. And it is saying 100 volt AC is applied across the same solenoid, the current drops to 0.5 ampere. And we are given also with the frequency of AC source, which is 150 root 3 by pi hertz. We are required to find the resistance and inductance of the solenoid. Now in this situation, we can directly write, if we are given with an inductor coil with inductance L and resistance R, and a DC voltage of 100 volt is connected, the current which will flow through it in a steady state, we can directly write, here the value of a steady current can be simply written as E by R. So this must be 100 divided by R, which is equals to 1 ampere. This implies the value of resistance of the inductance coil can be directly written as 100 ohms. That will be the answer to this problem. Now we are also required to find the inductance of this coil, for which we proceed with the second part, where it says, if for the same coil with the inductance L and resistance R, an AC EMF of 100 volt effective value is connected. We know well that in the situation of AC EMF, the current in circuit will be EMF divided by the impedance of the circuit, and in the situation of a series RL circuit, because in case of an inductor coil with some resistance, we consider L and R are connected in series combination. So here this value of Z can be written as root of R square plus XL square, and here the value of EMF is 100, so this 100 by root of R square plus XL square, its value should be 0.5 ampere. So in this situation, see what we are getting. The value of root of R square plus XL square is equals to, this will be 200. And in this situation, if we square the term, the value of XL square, we are getting, this is square of 200 is 40,000 minus R square. R square here will be 10,000. So this will be 30,000. That means the value of inductive reactance we are getting is square root of 30,000, that will be 100 root 3 ohms. This will be the value of inductive reactance, and here we know the value of XL is omega L. So this will give us the value of L, which is XL upon omega. So we can write here 100 root 3 divided by the value of omega is 2 pi F. This 2 pi and the frequency here is 150 root 3 divided by pi. Here pi gets cancelled out, root 3 also gets cancelled out, and this will be 100 by 300. It is 1 by 3 Henry. That will be the answer to this problem. So this is the inductance of this coil, and 100 ohm is the resistance in this coil.